The key aspect of this session with Pravesh is exactly what you've been hearing all this entire evening. Scale, 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 and more of scale, right? So Pravesh, welcome to F&B Talks.
Thank you everybody. Good evening, everybody.
So Pravesh, here's my thought. Look, most entrepreneurs or restaurateurs, entrepreneurs, logical people, right? you know, they always start small and they take it big, right? So 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, and so on and so forth. You started BYG, right? You started big. It is actually interesting and intriguing and fascinating that you were able to think and write a business plan for a 65,000 square feet large brew pub, which is one of the largest in Asia, probably the largest in Asia, right? What was happening here?
Obviously, I'll tell you about the larger part later, but then I did start small as well. It's not that I came out of I landed from the sky and said, hey, let me start some business like that. There was a lot of research which was done. There was a lot of gut feeling which we had. There was a lot of fearlessness between the partners. Very, very frankly, it was not something which was an easy decision because the funding required to open a business like this was extremely high. But before we got into the stage like this, it was important to understand what is an expertise of people who are bringing that together in this concept. Now answering why did we go into creating a format like this. So we did a little bit of research, and that little bit of research took about 2 years. And we understand how consumer preferences are changing in this diverse market. Each city in the country behaves very differently. Price points are very different. Spends are also very different. Flavor profiles are also very different. And Bangalore has been always given the benefit of climate. We wanted to utilize something. And in the last 20 years of my experience, I've seen the transition of the cuisine going from Chinese to Italian to pasta. And then there was sushi and sashimis and Japanese, and then it came to now as a regional ethnic cuisine. We have gone back to the roots, right? A typical Indian consumer who is jet setter, who has traveled across, all these IT people in Bangalore, they've all got a chance to travel abroad. They all have tried American food, they've all have tried Italian pastas, pizzas, but there is a question, what next? What do I eat? What do I go back to and eat in a restaurant, right? If you go to Vietnam, or Thailand, you will eat the local food. You will obviously try to explore that. A lot of times we do a mistake of thinking that Indian customer wants an international food, right? But he can have that food once or twice or thrice in a month. But what is it that he eats every day? We went into the flavor profile, understanding how the flavor profile continues to be the common factor within all sorts of cuisines. If you interestingly see, ginger and garlic is what Indians like a lot. So food wise, we were very strong that even in Chinese, gobi manchurian sells the maximum till today, right? And it has ginger and garlic. It is, if you take pastas or pizza, there is still garlic there, right? Even in chai which we drink, there is ginger which goes in. So we took that and we understood that the mix of the menu has to be based on the consumer portfolio, and this is the future, right? You can't be too experimental. You have to stay back to the base. Make sure that the product which you're going to create is going to cater to masses. Then once we got the product right, we got into the question of experience. So Bangalore or any other city, if you look at it fundamentally, is becoming tighter, be it offices, co-working spaces have opened up, cars are getting tighter, people don't want to travel out too much, and that's why cloud kitchen is working better these days. People want to go out and find their own downtime, how they can relax, how they can chill. Resorts, weekend gateways, they do fairly good amount of business. So we said, how about making a resortish restaurant in the city? Maybe a little bit on the periphery, but still in the city. Somebody was talking in the first, I think Vinny was talking about it, that why should I go to a restaurant, right? Which is that one restaurant, when I go to Delhi, somebody should say, go there. So we wanted to create an experiential restaurant, which becomes a must visit place when anybody comes to Bangalore. That was clearly in our thought, in our head. And we said we have to create a cultural destination, which is a larger than life destination, resortish. So if you go to Big Brewski, every element is natural. Water bodies, fishes, greenery, fire, torches everywhere. You don't get bored to see environment. And that's where the solution was. Our bottom line in the business plan was that this is a timeless. There is a factor of timelessness in the offering. There is no fad in the business. You will not get bored in the next 3 years, 4 years. There is no need of revamping the restaurant. Yes, we can play around the food, but the setup itself is going to be an asset space for us. And we can see ourselves going to 25 years. Maybe my grandson would like to say it. My grandfather built this property. And most of the microbreweries or breweries in Germany or European countries have been existing for almost more than 100 years, right? That is the cult which we wanted to bring. And put together all the energy between consumers' behaviors, lifestyle changes, menu preferences, space constraints, the need of going in. So till now, till before Big Brewski opened, it was about 5,000, 8,000, 10,000 square feet. So that is big, and that worked very well for us.